Hey, there you are. Hey, time for another weekend. Let's get busy on Back to the Homestead. It's a beautiful morning here on the homestead this Saturday morning. Not much wind, lots of clear skies. It looks like it's going to be a good, productive day. I tell you what, I'm excited to get out there and get my hands dirty. We found some fabric, a great deal on some fabric over at the nursery. Wind blown, but still intact and ready to go. We're gonna go pick that up in just a little bit. I've gotta empty this trailer out, get the dirt out of it, move the dirt about, and then we're gonna go over there and pick up that fabric. So what we're doing is we're still picking up resources. We're going out and about, picking up blackberries and raspberries and different things like that. We finished school last week, which was great. Glad to have that done. But right now, we're in spring mode. So most of what we're doing is just putting it together, grabbing hold of the pieces of the puzzle, and then we're pulling them out, putting them in a pile, finding all of our edge pieces, if you know what I'm saying. And then we're just basically just bringing it together. And eventually, one day at a time, after those pass, it'll all come together and it'll be done. And did I just say done? I don't guess any of us really believe that, right? So I do like finding good deals on stuff, and I think we found a pretty good deal on this fabric. It's windblown somewhat, got a free spike anyways. And so what we're gonna do is we're gonna cut this, trimming it up and getting it ready for overlap. And then we're going to lay it down that area back over here. Let me show you real quick what I'm talking about. Now I like using fabric. I've used fabric before on a homestead before the last one. I used cardboard on the last one. The problem we had was with cardboard, even though we stacked it about three layers thick, wetted it down till it was just sticking and glued to the ground. The problem we had with cardboard is the morning glories kept growing up through the cardboard, especially in the second year when the cardboard had been eaten away by the worms for the most part. We didn't have a problem with tape or anything like that. The main problem with cardboard is the morning glories. They kept punching through. They messed up the wood chips. We constantly were out there trying to dig those morning glories up. It was just a pain. The homestead before that, we used fabric, and we were in our eighth year in that homestead, and we didn't have a weed problem. Some of the weeds would grow on top of the fabric, maybe a dandelion or whatnot. We were able to pull that up pretty easily. Now, I like dandelions, don't get me wrong, but I don't want them growing where I don't want them growing. So we're using fabric on this homestead, and we're looking at the longevity. We want to have this fabric down for years. So I'm gonna continue laying this fabric out, laying the wood chips down, and organizing this side of the homestead. I debated on using these hay bales for compost, mixing the manure, which would be my nitrogen, along with the carbon and the straw and the hay. A lot of seeds in some of this hay, and I really don't want that in my garden on my beds. Plus, we've gotten a nice supply of compost. Not enough compost, but a nice supply of compost right now. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna spread this straw out and some of this hay out for the chickens when we get ready to move them over to this area. And what we're gonna do is just spread it out and let it rest. Let it get rained on, let it get manured, and maybe some of those seeds will germinate. We'll get some good grasses growing up here in this area as the chickens forage around in their coop and their run. Unlike the stuff we were spreading, straw doesn't have the seed content that hay has. Hay is full of seeds, alfalfa, things like that, but it's meant to be for the nutritional value. Straw is a little different. Doesn't have much nutritional value other than the carbon that's in it. So we're going to soak this and get this ready for some mulch. We have been moving plants along for far too long, just moving them from point A to point B, back to point A, and then to C. We've got our raspberries that we're going to place, and we've stuck them out here. And the back corner is where we're going to stick them. Now that's out and about, but raspberries don't give off but maybe once or twice a year, and as long as they stay watered, we're good to go. So we'll keep moving berries, we'll keep moving chips, and I'll catch back up with you at the end of this Saturday and I'll show you my progress. Well, we were going to look at today's progress here on Saturday, but I am tired and I work till dark. I'm going to sit back and enjoy that fire and enjoy the homestead as is anyways. And in the morning, I'll give you an update on the progress, or maybe even tomorrow afternoon. We'll see how the day goes. Well, the boys are playing on their trampoline, having a good time before their birthday party today. And we're watering a few plants this Sunday morning, trying to get things organized before we go off today. We've got a busy day. Some homesteading stuff and also some non-homesteading stuff. We're going to be going to church and also going to a boy's 10th birthday party. It's going to be fun. We also may have found some river rock that we've been looking for free over in Boise. We're going to go pick some up today, maybe. We'll see. We'll see how that turns out. So even though it's cloudy today, we're going to go ahead and keep watering, and maybe we'll walk around the homestead and see what we got done yesterday. Yesterday we picked up some grapes. We picked up Concord seedless and Concord seeded. Here the seeded grapes are better for juicing and for wine, but we'll see. I think the seedless grapes will be fun just to eat on. They're not going to cross, and even if they do, we're never going to grow the seeds to grow plants. These are probably the only 8 plants that we'll need, well, for probably for the rest of our lives. We also picked up some strawberries. We had no luck at picking up any strawberries in the community, and so but we did pick up a few other things in the community. Let's take a peek at some of the progress we've made. You see, we've got the trampoline moved and they're enjoying that. And we've got all this area covered up with bark. Trampolines moved from this area, and the place where we're going to put the chicken coop is a little more revealed. We started adding rock to edge everything, and you'll see here, and we're running low on rock, but most likely the coop will be right in this area on top of the grass. And then we also have some rock that we're edging to, in order to keep the grass down from spreading over there into the other side, and also to keep the wood bark from, you know, floating away or migrating over into the neighbor's yard. It also looks nice. Now we've extended out this area quite a bit, and we're going to extend it out even more. You see, we have the fabric ready to go. Here's one of our raised beds. Let's go take a peek at it real quick. We wanted to set the first raised bed in order to get an idea about where we're going to put everything. And the 4x8 beds, we're probably going to put 5 total. So we'll have one here, and then most likely we'll set one here. We may do 6 if we've got room and do one there. And then over where the dolly is and where the rock is, there'll be more raised beds in that area. We're going to extend it out. 5 or 6 raised beds just for kitchen garden, for quick harvest whenever we need something out of the kitchen. And then we'll also grow, you know, more of our canning and preserving garden in the back. Watering is going to be a problem. You know, when we start putting these beds together, I start thinking about watering. Here today, it's pretty cloudy, but this is spring here in Idaho. We'll go a couple of months during the summer where not one drop or any significant drop will actually come out of the sky, where it'll evaporate before it even hits the ground. Dry lightning and summer fires, they'll all happen. So I'm not real sure what to do as far as watering and how I'm going to manage that. We do have irrigation that's brought to the property. We also have a well, but we definitely don't want to just rely on our well, because it'll run 24/7 trying to water this much room, and so we don't want to do that. We're probably going to buy a portable pump, and we're probably going to pull from the irrigation, and I'll show you the pipes that are coming out of the ground real quick. Here's our well head here, and this is where we pump our water from. For the household, eating and drinking and all that, bathing and things like that. Here is our pipe coming from the district irrigation, our water rights here in Idaho. And water rights in Idaho are much different. Water rights in the West are much different than water rights in the East. We've learned that the hard way, especially when there's not much of it. When water is a commodity, hard to find, you know, it costs more. It takes more effort to get that stuff pumped around. Water harvesting is going to be one of our big projects. We have a lot of roof space, and all these downspouts every single spring produce quite a bit of water. And also during the fall, we get quite a bit of water. And that's when most important, because they tend to shut the irrigation off in mid-fall. And then you've still got late harvest coming in. Even before the tomatoes come ripe, they'll shut that water off, and then we'll be kind of stuck if we don't have plans ahead of time. We still have quite a bit of fabric from our fabric deal that we've got, and we'll end up using that most likely, getting that over into this next week and getting that taken care of. Hopefully this next weekend we'll start working on the chicken coop, because it's time. We've got birds that are too big for the cages we have them in, and it's time to get them out and about. And you'll see here how the chickens have just knocked over their water. They've knocked over their food. And they're chickens. They're ready for a coop. They're ready for a run. And they're ready to start turning that grass over for compost. And you'll see here how big the chicks have gotten. They've gotten huge. And especially that big black one there. That big. I don't know if that's an Ulster Lop or not. Who knows? Who knows? But this, good friends, that's a rooster. That's a rooster for sure. Look at him. And you see the other one? See, that's a hen. See her? That's a hen. There we go. I love finding free resources. And you'll see here where we scored on a bunch of river rock. And we got a couple more loads. But they're way over in Boise. So we're going to be taking our time. Probably going over Tuesday to get some more. And you see here the rock that's down here before. I'm kind of wanting to remove that. And make a more stable roadside. And use the river rock as my decorative rock, and all this rock, take it over by the fence where I'm laying my fabric, and I'll show you that in just a little bit. We've already gotten some, but we'll get more. And rock is heavy and it's expensive too. So I see a lot of people spraying this year. I don't know why I've seen more people spraying this year than I did last year. They're spraying their dandelions. And I like dandelions, but dandelions, they do get out of hand sometimes. Let me show you something cool. Best way I know how to get rid of dandelions is just like this. Look at that, root and all. You know what that is? That's rabbit snack right there. Good old-fashioned rabbit snack. What about that nasty dude? I tell you what, look like he's got some ant friends hanging around. A little bit of that, that's all she wrote. Will it come back? Maybe, but who cares, right? There's always the hoe. Look at this dude right here. Friendly as can be. Watch, he want to jump back in. You want to come over here? Come over here. Come on. Come on. Come on my hand. Come on my hand. There you go. This is my rooster. I know he's a rooster, and I feel bad because he's going to have to go someplace else, and they're probably going to eat him. But that's just the way it goes. Let's see if he'll go back onto that roost. He's a good bird. He'll flop around a little bit. That's right. That's right. You in safe hands. You in safe hands. There you go. There you go. Anyway, as roosters go. So, you know, if you have a poison that you know causes cancer and you put it on your ground, I mean, what are you asking for? You're asking for cancer. At least maybe someone else getting the cancer. So what do? You simply don't spray the poison. Now, I'm not real sure if there's ever a case where you could spray poison. I've been tempted before when it comes to morning glories, I tell you what. But poison in itself, you know, I had a talk with an oncologist not long ago about cancer. And I asked, why do we have so much more cancer now than we did, say, 100 years ago? And she reported that it was better detection. And I say horse wash on that. And I told her that. I said, it's horse pucky. I said, let me explain to you. We would have better detection now and have a better survival rate. Back then, we would have detected cancer and mortality rates. So, no, I'm not really buying that. I think we have something wrong with our environment. And I think part of it is the vast amounts of chemicals that we're spraying on everything and what we're eating. So that's one of the reasons that we homestead. It's a beautiful evening here on the homestead. I just love the light here in Idaho, especially in the evening times when we get these long, drawn out shadows. I mean, they just cast long and they stay long. It's just beautiful here in Idaho. Really enjoy homesteading here. Isn't that something? That's just beautiful. So that about does it for this week on Back to the Homestead. Hey, join us next week for another update. We're going to get a lot of things done next weekend. Most likely, we're going to start building that chicken coop right over there. I'm looking forward to that. Check us out on Facebook, check us out on Twitter, and also our Instagram site. We've got all these, and you can see those on backtothehomestead.com. All one word, nice secure site, https://www.backtothehomestead.com. Other than that, that's about it. We're going to wrap it up for this weekend. We'll see you next week on Back to the Homestead. Thank you.
I made this.